With just about every household device connecting to the internet nowadays, it's more important than ever to have an understanding about how these devices connect to the internet. Today, we're going to start off with a very basic building block topic, IP addresses. We're going to take it at a very high level. We're going to keep this simple, but we're going to talk about the most important information when it comes to IP addresses. So what exactly is an IP address? For starters, IP stands for Internet Protocol. So an Internet Protocol address is basically just like a name tag for your devices. It allows your devices to identify each other, and that's how information is sent between your devices or even between your devices and the internet. It's a little obscured by a technology called DNS or domain name system. But when your laptop, for example, goes out to the internet and goes to a website, it's actually traveling to that IP address of the website. So even a website like CNN.com, that website translates to an IP address, and that's how your devices access that website. So where do these IP addresses come from? Well, when your devices connect to a network, for example, your home Wi-Fi network, that's when they get assigned an IP address. And these devices, throughout their lifetime, they can have many different IP addresses. It's not like they come out of the box from the store with an IP address assigned. That's very important to understand up front. So what devices get IP addresses? Well, honestly, any device that can connect to either your home network or the larger internet, all those devices receive IP addresses. So obviously, we're talking about your mobile phone, your laptop, if you have an Alexa device or any smart device in your home, smart washing machines, all of these devices will have IP addresses. Smart speakers that connect to your home Wi-Fi network. Think about anything that you connect or set up to connect with your Wi-Fi, smart TVs. All of those devices will need IP addresses, which allows them to communicate with other devices either on your home network or it allows them to connect to the internet. So what do IP addresses look like? Well, here are two examples. You're probably more familiar with IPv4 addresses. That's because these addresses are used to identify the devices in your home network. But the reason that IPv6, which is a newer development, the reason that that was created is just because of the number of devices connecting to the internet nowadays. IPv4 addresses are smaller, therefore there are fewer combinations of IP addresses available that people can use. As you can see here, IPv4 addresses, they have 4.3 billion IP addresses that are usable. That's not enough in today's day and age with everything becoming connected devices, everything is connecting to the internet, so we're eventually going to run out of these IPv4 addresses. That's why IPv6 was created. And the only thing you need to know here, I know it looks a lot more confusing, but the only thing you need to know here is that there are many more IP addresses available with IPv6. When it comes to IPv6 addresses, there are 340 undecillion available IP addresses. Honestly, that doesn't even sound like a real number, but just keep in mind that IPv6 IP addresses basically opens the door to an unlimited amount of devices connecting to the internet. This might be a lot of information to take in at this point, but what's important to understand is just that you can recognize what an IP address looks like. Specifically, with an IPv4 address, you will have four numbers separated by three dots. So here we have 192.168.0.1. This is the IP address that's usually assigned to the router in people's home networks. And I know what you might be thinking, how can every router have the same IP address? Well, this is a little bit of a more complex topic. What's really happening here is these IP addresses are called private IP addresses. They're not accessible by the larger internet. Whereas websites, for example, those are public IP addresses. They're accessible and available to be reached on the internet. We'll get into the difference between public and private IP addresses in another video. Again, what's important to understand is that you know what an IP address looks like. Okay, now let's talk about how your devices get IP addresses. And there are two different ways that devices can get assigned IP addresses. The first is with a dynamic IP address. This is what usually happens in most people's home networks. Their router, when a device joins the home network, has a pool of available IP addresses, and it will automatically assign your device with an IP address from this pool of available addresses. Now, these are dynamic IP addresses, which means that devices don't get the same IP address every time. So here, let's walk through an example. Here in your home network, you have your router with the 192.168.0.1 IP address. You have a laptop, which is a 192.168.0.2, a desktop computer at 192.168.0.3, and a printer at 192.168.0.4. Now, let's say with this laptop, we go and we take it to work and it leaves this home network. So let's say it leaves the home network. During this time, while you're at work with your laptop, your friend comes to your house and connects to your home network with a different device. Let's say it's a mobile device. This same 192.168.0.2 IP address gets assigned to your friend's phone because when you left your home network, that IP address went back into the pool of available IP addresses that your router could use to assign to devices. So what happens, say after work, you come back home, your friend is still at your house with their mobile phone connected to your Wi-Fi network. Now your laptop gets 192.168.0.5. It doesn't get the IP address that was previously assigned to it, that .2 IP address, because that IP address is currently in use by your friend's phone. Therefore, it's not available in the pool of IP addresses that your router can assign to devices. And that's why your laptop gets a new IP address, this .5 IP address. This is the nature of dynamic IP addresses. Every time you connect to a network, you get randomly assigned an IP address. It could be different every time you connect to the network, but just keep in mind, it's a pretty fluid situation. A good analogy to think about this is in an apartment complex. If you move into an apartment building, let's say you get apartment number 5, you then decide to move somewhere else for a year. You go, you leave that apartment building, and then you decide to come back to that same apartment building a year later and rent another apartment from them. Well, chances are at this point, your number 5 apartment has already been leased to somebody else. So you'll receive a new apartment number when you sign up for a new lease for the apartment building. Although your address has changed and you have a different apartment number, people still know where you are and they can still reach you by your mailing address. And that's basically the essence of IP addresses. Although your device might get assigned a different IP address from your router, your other devices can still communicate with it on your home network because it has that IP address that's identifying it. In some situations, however, you might want your device's IP address to always remain the same. Even if it disconnects from that given network and later reconnects to it, maybe you still want it to have that same IP address so that way other devices know that it's always at a given IP address. This is the case with websites, for example. Could you imagine if the IP address of websites constantly changed? It would be nearly impossible to find your favorite websites. And that's why with these websites, you get static IP addresses. So now let's walk through an example of your home network again, but using static IP addresses. So here we are, we have the same devices as our previous example. You have your laptop at .2, desktop at .3, printer at .4. Again, let's say we take our laptop to work for the day. So that comes off of the home network. Your friend comes to your house with their mobile phone. And see right here off the bat, this .5 IP address is assigned to this mobile device because this .2 IP address is reserved for your laptop. So here, when your laptop comes back after work, you reconnect to your home network. There it is, that .2 IP address is still assigned to your laptop. It doesn't change because it's statically assigned. I've previously made another video how to statically assign IP addresses to the devices in your home network, but for the vast majority of the devices that you have, this dynamically assigned IP address is going to be just fine. Your devices can still communicate with each other. Your devices just might get different IP addresses. every time they reconnect to your home network. Going back to our apartment complex analogy, a static IP address would be like basically buying an apartment in an apartment building. Let's say you buy apartment number 5. If you go and move somewhere else for a year and then you come back, you will still have that apartment number 5, regardless of whether you're living in the building or not. New people can go and join and sign a lease for that apartment building, but they're not going to get assigned apartment number 5 because you bought that one. That one is permanently assigned to you. These are the basics of all you need to know about IP addresses. Basically, every time a device connects to a network, it receives an IP address. And these IP addresses are used so your devices can communicate with each other and then the larger internet as well when they're accessing websites. I'd love to see in the comments section what else you'd like to learn about IP addresses or how your devices connect to the internet. And in the meantime, I'll be making additional videos that break down other topics that might be a little bit more complex than the basics here. As always, thanks for watching this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.